You know what? Adobe Flash gets a bit of a bad rap, even as far back as when it was Macromedia Flash. It doesn't help that it was supposed to do vector-based graphics and it ends up being used for sprites instead, or that it humps your CPU like a drunken frat boy trying to make it with a mechanical bull. But I've spent so much time watching playing games powered by Flash that I have to admit it works. Then again, I'm the kind of person who'll spend 700 quid on a new PC and then put up something like Alex Kidd in Shinobi World. That might be a factor. And it doesn't help that Flash has been used by many a rando to churn out god-awful crap. It was pretty much the Unity engine of its day. Point is, a game powered by Flash, or Unity for that matter, is not necessarily a bad thing. And with that, I'll talk about Machinarium, which is as difficult to pronounce as it is to spell. Released all the way back in 2009, this comes from Anamita Design, a group of 7 developers from the Czech Republic, and not a terribly easy name to say either, nor a location I could point to on a map, because I'm allergic to geography. Machinarium isn't their first or last game, it's not even their first point-and-click adventure. If Samorost or Botanicula sound familiar, that was them too, but Machinarium kicked them off as far as the whole doesn't-need-to-run-in-a-browser era is concerned. The story opens on a junkyard-looking world, which is thankfully different enough not to give me Deponia flashbacks. A flying robot dumps some trash out its arse, and with it, our protagonist. And that's your intro. Nope, really, that's it. From main menu to gaining control, that's what you start with. From there you pull yourself together, quite literally, and commence exploration. Far from being plotless, the game merely tells the story in a more natural way rather than grabbing the camera and shouting, "This are what has happened" in your face. It's subtle, or in other words, the exact opposite of what I just did. It starts off quite linear, a lot of your early chat will be about what room you got stuck in rather than what point did you get to, but before long it'll open up. So I'll get the basic stuff out of the way first. It's one button controls and an interface which shows nothing but the lovely metallic world. Both of these features work fine, although the controls aren't my favourite. I like to be able to look at things. But there's also the fact that this happens when you right-click on a Flash applet, so it makes sense. The inventory annoys me though. You get to it by moving the mouse to the top of the screen. Responds nice and quick when you're playing in full screen, but when you're in windowed mode, say because you're trying to record footage and you don't trust your recording software with keyboard shortcuts, you have to hover near the top of the window for a second. Fiddlier than it has to be, and I'm surprised at the number of times I have to say keyboard shortcut for inventory. For God's sake folks, Deponia got that one right. Also hidden up there is the in-game hint system. There's this button which merely hints at what you need to do in a given area via the power of daydreams, or there's a full walkthrough which is accessed by this thing. Seems a bit daft to be honest. It's not as if game FAQs or UHS didn't exist 6 years ago. Still, at least the in-game one is spoiler free. There's a few things Machinarium does which make it stand out from the usual pointy-click fare. First of all, the controls. Whilst a game of this type would normally let you walk wherever you want all willy-nilly, here you're restricted to walking between certain hotspots. It's not like Tormentum Dark Sorrows where they merely switch rooms and move your character sprite around. These guys are doing a far better job of disguising their limitations. From these hotspots you can interact with any items that are within reach. The reason for this control method is most likely due to the thing I'm about to tell you. When fully assembled, your character can stretch himself tall or short himself short at will. Lets you reach tall areas and go through small holes, for example. I could sure as hell use that next time I go to a gig. As far as quick, easy ways to increase the number of puzzles go, it works well. The second thing which makes this game stand out is there's no dialogue. Any communication takes place through these thought bubbles, showing a wee animation of what the character is saying.
Okay, I can't hold this off any longer. I think this is the cutest protagonist I've ever played as.
Well, I suppose Boogle from Torrin's Passage came close, but you don't really play as him. Oh my god! Look at that wee wiggle when he's in short mode, it's adorable. The thought bubbles get used for daydreams and memories. One of those usually ends up being cuter than the other. You'll come across some bully robots in the story, and the animations of them doing their bully thing broke my heart a little. It's cartoonish as all hell, but I'm sold. I totally feel for the wee guy. If nothing else, it gives you motivation to keep playing in the hopes that you'll get some kind of revenge for people being total dicks in the past. Revenge that in the real world would get you arrested, sued, probably ruin your life. Not the kind of thing someone should be wasting their time thinking about at the age of 20 goddamn 9. A motivation like that could come in handy because these are some puzzles, ranging from item rubbing to logic puzzles to fetch quests to mini-games. Forgive me for bringing up Tormentum again, but it's the closest match out of everything I've reviewed. If you were intrigued by Tormentum but you thought it was too easy, Machinarium could be for you. Logically, the only real difference between the puzzles in these games is difficulty, and yet it feels entirely different. The whole I might be playing a hidden object game feel doesn't happen in Machinarium, it feels like a solid pointy click the whole way through.
I'm not trying to go back on my Tormentum review or anything, but I've got a preference, okay? Speaking of, there's one or two timed puzzles in Machinarium that aren't to my taste. They're pretty fair though, certainly nothing that spoils the experience, but again, I have my preferences. And before I wrap this up, I know you're eager to go home and all, I'm going to say the same thing I'm sure many people have said about this game. It's charming. Not everything about the game is cutesy, it's pretty much the protagonist and a couple of stray NPCs, but I could feel like I was playing something good. Everything comes together in such a subtle yet wonderful way. The artwork's muted colours and aversion to straight lines, the way the sound design slots scenes together or merely matches the mood of the place you're in, the way the music casts an otherworldly, mechanical yet organic tone over the whole game. Reminds me of Primordia in a big way, which is weird because this came out 3 years earlier. It's really good, I'll just bloody say it. 3 years of development well spent. And since these guys aren't done being perfect humans, there's even a free demo you can play in your browser. No need to download any damn thing. Unless you don't have Flash installed, of course. Everything in Machinarium merges together into something cohesive, something that feels right when you're playing it, something I think you're going to enjoy if you decide to pick it up. More than enough to make you forget you're playing a Flash game. It's not a problem when you're playing something this good.